What's up, vinyl community? It's Todd Guy, the Thrashing Zombie, back again with another video. Just cut out not too long ago, so excuse the hair. This is a video that was inspired by Ron Haggerty's last video. Maybe it's done on since then, I don't know, but one I just watched yesterday about his top 10 favorite bands of all time. I think it was all time. And it inspired me to do the same thing. I never made a video about my top favorite albums or bands or anything like that, so I figured I'll do one for my top 10 favorite bands of all time. This is just metal. It's just heavy metal. So it's the top 10 favorite heavy metal bands. I have other favorite bands that aren't metal, but I figured I'd do heavy metal. I am the Thrashing Zombie, but anyway, so we're listening to, if you can see right here, this is Thin Lizzy live. If you can hear it, it's not very loud. So it kind of follows the same rules he did. You know, bands have to have 3 or more albums. It has to be, what was the other thing? Something I was listening to in the last 10 years, I've never stopped listening to, or something. I don't remember the exact rules, but in the last 10 years, this is a pretty definite list, I think, for me. The top 3, anyway, maybe even the top 4, are like locked right in place. Those have been my 3 favorites ever since I was a teenager. So. I'll tell you right now, there's only 1 of the big 4 on here. Of, Metallica, Megadeth, Anthrax, and Slayer. There's only 1 of those on this list. I do like those bands, but they're not in my top 10. Top 20, maybe. So let's just get started with this. Number 10 is Blossom and Jetsam. I remember hearing Flotsam and Jetsam back in high school. Where I heard them, saw a video, maybe some song off this album, or maybe off of Doomsday for the Deceiver, and I decided to check them out. this one's the one that really caught my attention. I mean, I don't have any other albums by them. They're not easy to find. I mean, I could buy CD reissues, vinyl. I haven't seen them anywhere, any of the other albums. So, I mean, I'd love to get some more of their vinyl. I have this one and Doomsday for the Deceiver, and that's it. But just this one, I mean, they constantly change their... They've constantly changed their sound from this album to the next one. People say they're not technically straight up thrash. This one I think was straight up thrash. Other albums, they've got more of a melody to them. They got some elements of power metal in there and straight up heavy metal. excuse me. So, I mean, but I could listen to Flotsam and Jetsam all day. That's number 10. Excuse me for a second. Alright. Number 9. Testament. Testament was a band I heard on the radio back when Practice What You Preach came out. My radio station around here, 99 Rock, they play, I see back then, I'm not sure what they were playing, might have been newer stuff. Now it's like a lot of new metal. They play a lot of Ghost and Shinedown and bands like that, Five Finger Death Punch, the more mellow stuff of that. Anyway, they had back in the day, they had what was called the 99-Minute Nightmare. It started, I think, at 11:30. and it went until around 12:45. Something like that. Anyway, it was 99 minutes, approximately. And I was listening to that on the radio, my stupid little clock radio. And that song came out, Practice Is What You Preach. And I was like, wow, that's good stuff. So I think, wasn't the next day, but a few days after that, I went searching for Testament, Practice What You Preach, and I bought the cassette. Fell in love with that album. Kind of dropped off as my favorite Testament album, though. It's listening to it now. I don't know if it was remastered or what it was, but I noticed things in there now that I never noticed before, like the kick drum, the bass drum. I could hear when he's stepping on the pedal. It's like a clicking noise, and it's very prominent to my ears. I mean, the music's still great, it's just I can't get past that clicking, so that kind of drops it down a little bit. But Testament's still on my number 9 favorite band. I had to pick a favorite album by them. Might be this one, or the New Order. New Order is really great for the older stuff. Probably Souls of Black was okay. It was kind of a Practice What You Preach too, but it was good. But I have to probably pick Souls of Black for my favorite older one, and this one probably for my newer one. And Dark Roots of Earth, just below this one. So that's number 9. Okay, number 8. This band, I heard a few songs by them when I was in high school. Somebody else had their music. Didn't really get into them in high school. Didn't really get into them until probably 10, 11 years ago. I got back into listening to heavy metal aggressively like I used to. So I don't even know if this is, but I'm not really following his rules to the exact letter, but this is one of my favorite bands now, and I'm looking for all their older stuff. This is their latest album, it's Obituary. Originally I always thought that they sounded kind of the same music. I mean, it kind of does, but it's just, is it John Tandy, the lead singer, I think? Anyway, his singing is just so deep, and it sounds to me like what probably Bigfoot would sound like if he was singing, I guess. But listening to all their other stuff, really listening, it doesn't actually sound the same. It's just good stuff. Great Floridian death metal that they love doing, apparently. So that's number 8. Number 7. I think I told a story about how I came across this album. I saw the cassette tape in a little record store inside the hospital. And it fell in my pocket when I was, a teenager. And I've loved this album ever since. I've loved this band ever since. I don't have any, I have 3 of their albums, the first 3, but I do like the rest of their stuff. I haven't been able to find any of the other stuff either, but it does pop up in my streaming when I click shuffle on all my music. I do hear that some later stuff. It's Entombed. They did change a little bit after this album with Wolverine Blues. Went a little more what they call rock and roll. Not rock and roll, death and roll. Sorry. Got the same kind of guitars and singing a little bit. The singing's more clear. Clean vocals in a way. I still like that music though. I would definitely buy another vinyl of theirs from that era if I could. I can't remember the names of their other albums though. But yeah, Entombed, I spin this one once a month generally, or I stream it once a month. The Left Hand Path, Clandestine, and Wolverine Blues, three great albums. Along with the other stuff, is great. I can listen in tuned all the time. What's this? Number six. It's another band that's fairly new. It's the only really new band that came out in the last... came out in the 2000s, I guess. I stumbled upon them on YouTube, I think, for a video. At first, I didn't really like them. The video was good. I liked that song. And I found them on the streaming service, and I kind of listened to them. And one of the albums, the older albums, the singing was really low. I could barely hear it. And I was just kind of, I kind of got rid of it. I didn't listen to it again. But then this album came out, and I listened to this album, Skeleton Witch, Serpents Unleashed. They are a black thrash metal band. I don't know what it is. The music's great, and the singing goes well with the music. I went back and I re-listened to the other albums, and I don't know if they remastered maybe the first or second one where the singing was kind of low, I thought, but I could actually hear it now. So I went and I bought all the CDs. I didn't bring any of the CDs out. Went and bought all the CDs. I have all the Skeleton Witch stuff, except for the latest album, which is straight up black metal. But this, I love listening to this. The songs are short. They're 3 minutes, maybe. I think there might be one that's four, but most of the songs are under 3 minutes long. And just the way they compose the songs and the speed and the veracity of the playing, just astounding, and I just love it. I mean, it gets me pumped up, like if I'm heading to work or if I'm having a bad day, I'll pop Skeleton Witch on and it just clears my head and I feel great afterwards. Definitely not for people who are really religious, I guess, because it is black thrash and they do have elements of, I don't know the right words, God bashing or speaking of satanic stuff. But if you just get past that and realize, okay, they're not really into this, it's just an act. Listen to the music, it's good music. And if you get past the vocals, a lot of people don't like the vocals because they're very harsh and almost screechy. But I like them a lot. Definitely. Number six. And number five. Hold on. I need a drink here. And five here. This is another band. Don't remember where I heard these guys originally either. Creator, Gods of Violence. Originally I only listened to their Extreme Aggression album, and at one point I think I had the Flag of Hate EP on cassette, which I wish I still had now because that's probably worth a little bit. That one I didn't like because it was too harsh, and the vocals didn't really understand what he was saying. So I think I may have heard Terrible Certainty at one point in high school as well, which wasn't bad. I still think that's not one of their best albums, even though Toxic Trace is good and One of Us is good. But Creator, they have gone from almost death metal type to melodic, a melodic thrash metal. And they just constantly, they're not one of the bands that have put out albums that are great all the time. I'm not going to say they have. The majority, yes, they have put out great albums. There's been one or two missteps. Outcast wasn't the greatest. Endorama, I'm not sure what they were doing with that. I do like that album though, but it wasn't, did not sound like Creator. But every time a Creator album's coming out, I get excited. I know there's gonna be, the majority of the songs on there are gonna be great. Okay, now we're up to number 4. And this is one album that Ron Haggerty had on his list. I have two on here that Ron had on his list. Not in the same order, though. This is Death. Spiritual Healing was... This isn't Spiritual Healing. Spiritual Healing was the one I listened to originally that got me into Death. Never went looking for anything else when I got that album, because at the time, I just listened to what I had, and I've always been kind of short on money, so still am. But in the last probably 15 years now, I've been getting into more music and been researching more stuff and realizing, oh, these bands had so many albums. And then I go and look for them, and I listen to them on streaming services, and then I have to go buy the CD because I want to listen to it in my car, because my car doesn't have Bluetooth. So, I got all the Death CDs, and I got 3 Death records. And like everybody says, this is a band that has never released a bad album in their entire career. They're what? 1, 2, 3, 6 albums? Every single one just seems to get better and better. Chuck was a god. I mean, I can say that. He was a guitar god. And he always surrounded himself with the best musicians he could find for the album. Death is my number 4 favorite band. From Scream Bloody Gore all the way down to Sound of Perseverance. Every freaking album is a still, well, it's not really, I can't say thrasher piece because they're not thrash. Technical death metal, progressive death metal, whatever you want to call it. As each album came out, it got more and more progressive and more technical. I wish Chuck was alive today, because he would have done some amazing things. Maybe him and Cliff Burton could have got together and done something. Could you imagine that? Cliff Burton and Chuck Schuldiner playing an album together, doing something. That would be like a dream for me. But Death. Spiritual Healing was the first album I heard, and in the last 15 years I started looking for all their other stuff, and buying their other stuff. Now we're on to the top 3. These 3, actually those 4, I think Death, yeah, those 4 are locked in for my favorite 4 albums. So this one. Overkill. Ron Haggerty's number 1. Overkill is an amazing band. Love Overkill. Not as much as Ron Haggerty. Not as much as Darcy 639 Lives either. Both of them are huge, huge Overkill fans. I thought I was too, but watching their videos, I'm not as big as they are. I love Overkill, and what they both say, Overkill has never released a bad album. There's just some that are better than others. why did this only reach my top three? These two other bands are two bands that I've been into forever, and I never stopped listening to them, even when I wasn't listening to metal. I did stop listening to Overkill, and it was after WFO, I think. I didn't listen to any new Overkill until the Electric Age came out. But I did listen to some of their older stuff. I didn't listen to... I'll get to that. but Overkill, as I've shown in my videos, I have been finding a lot of Overkill albums. Some are reissues, some are new. Overkill's great. Ever since I saw Elimination on MTV, I bought The Years of Decay. Horoscope came out, and I bought that. Then I Hear Black came out after that, I bought that. WFO, I bought that. I think I bought Under the Influence after that. And then kind of dropped off. And then in the 2000s, when I got back in, probably 2006, I got back in the metal again, and I started looking for other stuff, and I found all the other albums they had, you know, like From the Underground and Below, and Relics, and what were the other ones? Killbox 13, and Ironbound. Overkill. Number 3. On to number 2. This is a band, came out in 87, put out 3 albums, and then disbanded. Didn't release another album until the early 2000s when they got back together. They did a benefit show for Chuck Billy at his, for his cancer, I think. Then they released an amazing run of albums. And this is another band that's never put out a bad album. That's Death Angel. My number 2. I've always loved Death Angel. I had their Ultraviolence, Frogs of the Park, and Act 3 on cassette. And those rotated through my car for months and months and months. Even though nobody else really liked Death Angel, but I did. And I would play them all the time. When I heard that they disbanded, I got upset, and then I bought the band that some of the guys formed called The Organization. But 2 albums, I believe. I bought both of those just to try to get my Death Angel fix. Wasn't really the same. I mean, they were okay albums, but they were nothing like Death Angel. And then in the 2000s, I happened to come across something somewhere, YouTube maybe, I saw a video for Death Angel. Just like Testaments album there that I didn't know they made. Video I'd never seen, song I'd never heard. I realized, wait a minute, they put out another album? And I found out at that point they put out 2 albums already. So I got back into Death Angel and haven't looked back. I don't even know what to say about Death Angel because they're so great, in my opinion. They are like one of those bands that's never put out a bad album, and they constantly try to make the best album they can. It's great. And live, they are pretty incredible. Now my number 1. I have been a fan of this band since forever. As you know, this is one of the top big 4 bands. So, it is Anthrax. My number 1 favorite band ever, metal band, is Anthrax. I've been an Anthrax fan ever since Among the Living. It's never wavered from number one. Even everybody else said that Metallica was their favorite, or Megadeth was their favorite, Slayer was their favorite. And I looked at them and say, Anthrax is mine. And they all looked at me like I had two heads, because Anthrax isn't like the other three. I mean, Slayer has that kind of satanic sound, scary stuff, you know, the speed. Like, and then Metallica is like the big band, you know, everybody knows Metallica. Megadeth has the riffs and the solos. Anthrax, at the time, back then, they were just having fun. They were clean singing. They were singing about comic book stuff like Judge Dredd and Stephen King books. Like, actually, the song was I Am the Law, Judge Dredd, I Am the Law. They're singing about Stephen King books, which is Among the Living. And Skeleton in the Closet was based on a novella by Stephen King called Apt Pupil. And then in State of Euphoria, they did Misery Loves Company, which was based on the Stephen King book Misery. They just like to have fun with their lyrics, and that's what I liked about them. The last two albums weren't like them about having fun. A lot of it was more serious and weren't as thrashy. They have a lot of, they have some thrash elements in here. It's great that Joey's back. But I still, Anthrax, my number one, will always be. I will never stop being a fan of Anthrax. They put out a couple duds with John Bush, and Fistful of Metal, wasn't a fan really, but Spreading the Disease, Among the Living, State of Euphoria, Persistence of Time, Sound of White Noise, all great albums. And then a couple with John Bush, you know, Volume 8, The Third is Real, Stomp 442, a couple songs that are okay, and then We Come For You All, which great, great album in my opinion. A couple songs could have been dropped from that, but otherwise it was a great album. And then Worship Music and For All Kings, amazing, amazing. So Anthrax, number one. And that is my top 10 favorite metal bands. So thank you, Ron Haggerty, for inspiration for doing that, because I thought that was a good idea. I mean, you didn't tell people to do it or anything. I just thought I'd do it, just become part of that. So thank you very much. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment if you like. I try to get back to everybody that leaves a comment. If you hated this video, let me know. If you don't like my shirt, let me know. If you don't like the video, give me a thumbs down. Whatever. Rock on.